disappeared 4.5 billion years ago. Few of us are able to realize how much this is, because a person's life spans only a few decades. The fauna that appeared on Earth consisted of primitive creatures that evolved over several billion years. Single-celled organisms gradually learned to photosynthesize and obtain their own nutrients. One of the main niches for the prosperity of life before dinosaurs was occupied by these interesting creatures, trilobites. The time of their heyday and death was the entire Paleozoic era, which began 550 million years ago. When the first trilobites appeared, none of the creatures had yet reached land, and when the last trilobite died, the ancestors of mammals and dinosaurs were already roaming the forests, and during all this time there were so many trilobites that in numbers and diversity of species they exceeded most of the groups of multicellular animals that lived then. If the Mesozoic era can be called the era of dinosaurs, then the Paleozoic era can be called the era of trilobites. Trilobites look similar in appearance to modern wood lice isopodous crustaceans, which may have occupied their niches after extinction. But these are not crustaceans, but a separate class of arthropods, very primitive, with some structural features, it is believed, reminiscent of polychaete worms. They didn't even have jaws, and they crushed food with special outgrowths of the three front pairs of legs. Over 15,000 species of trilobites are known, from the smallest, no more than a few millimeters in length, to almost a meter long. They were different, smooth, lumpy, spiky, with huge eyes, small and no eyes at all, with long branching outgrowths, with a body consisting of two segments or several dozen, in the same place, without interfering with each other. Dozens of species of trilobites with shells of various shapes could live. Their diet and lifestyle were very different. Most of them crawled along the bottom and ate detritus, algae, and small benthos. Their stomach was located at the front end of the body, between the eyes, where the brains of decent creatures should be located. Some trilobites spent their lives buried entirely in silt. These had eyes on stalks to stick them out. Like many marine arthropods, trilobites passed through the planktonic larval stage in their development, and some small trilobites led a planktonic existence all their lives. They have huge eyes, and when folded, large unprotected holes remained on the sides of the shell, the exit points for long swimming limbs. Swimming trilobites acquired wide and flat tail shields. Such species had light shells and many processes that acted as hydrofoils to float in the water column. Morning iata by some groups of trilobites in some cases may be associated with life in silt or in waters strongly agitated by currents in silt accumulation zones. In others, with life in the dark at great depths. Some species of trilobites were predators in Sweden. Traces of some animals living in the ground and traces left by trilobites were discovered. In this case, the trace of the trilobite covers the trace of an animal living in the ground, and it breaks off, the trilobite ate it. In Yakutia, trilobites were found with preserved particles of the bodies of sponges and brachiopods in the intestines. Some trilobites had a completely atrophied digestive tract, and they obtained nutrients through symbiosis with bacteria living near underwater volcanic springs. Other trilobites dug complex networks of tunnels in the ground in which they lived. In this form, they were discovered in a Swedish limestone quarry. The details of the underground life of trilobites are still unknown. They may have been hiding in the tunnels from predators like the nautiluses that scoured the Paleozoic oceans in search of prey. Or perhaps they used the water flowing through the tunnels to oxygenate their gills, as some modern lobsters do. Like all other arthropods, trilobites molt from time to time. The shed exoskeletons sometimes lie in large piles, apparently trilobites, like modern crabs and lobsters, gathered together during molting to protect each other. In addition, trilobites were discovered that died when they lined up in long chains, apparently. This is the oldest example of a nomadic line now found among crustaceans. Perhaps trilobites also undertook seasonal migrations. With all their diversity, they all resembled each other, and when you see a fossilized trilobite, you can always immediately say that it is a trilobite and not something else. Their very name trilobites means three-lobed. Their shell consisted of three sections, a central or axial, and two flattened lateral ones on both sides. Many fossilized remains of trilobites have damage indicating that they were hunted by fish, before them by cephalopods, and even earlier by various strange creatures like anomalocaris. To protect themselves, trilobites learned to curl up into a ball, like woodlice trams. Some grew spikes, horns, and other cunning squiggles on their shells. Many trilobites were frightened before death and were found in this position. During their lifetime, their chitinous shells were saturated with mineral salts, which made them literally stone. After death, for millions of years spent in the earth, shell minerals are usually replaced by other compounds, a process common in fossils. However, the compound eyes of many trilobites remained unchanged, the same as during life. Particularly impressive are the eyes of some trilobites found in the Hamar-Langdad Formation in Morocco. They are green, ranging from turquoise to emerald. It turned out that in compound eyes, lenses consisting of calcite with an admixture of magnesium were preserved. A study using an electron microscope showed that some trilobites have preserved their eyes almost as they were during the life of these long-extinct creatures. The lenses have not been replaced, since they are actually single crystals of calcite. They even retained their optical properties. The atoms in them are ordered in such a way that the optical axis of the crystals coincides with the optical axis of the lens. Different species of trilobites, belonging to dozens of families and orders, have mastered different ecological niches. Most of them were mud eaters crawling along the bottom, but there were also free-swimming species, even predators. As already mentioned, trilobites became completely extinct more than 200 million years ago. The only animals living today that are remotely similar to them are horseshoe crabs. They also appeared in the Ordovician period, but unlike trilobites, five of their species have survived to this day. These living fossils live in several parts of the world ocean and are similar to trilobites both in their lifestyle and in many anatomical details. But although they descend from a common ancestor, horseshoe crabs belong to a completely different class of arthropods. Perhaps somewhere on the ocean floor the last of the trilobite tribe are hiding. Their discovery would be a sensation, moreover, than the discovery of living dinosaurs, whose era is only 60 million years away from ours. And such sensations happen quite often in recent years. Moreover, trilobites are found not in the depths of the ocean, but in the most populated places in Russia. So, back in 2007, creatures unknown to science were discovered in one of the abandoned pits in Chelyabinsk. Around the same time, these same palm-sized creatures were apparently seen somewhere in the Moscow region. And last year, there was a report about trilobites caught in some pond and taken to the Alma-Ata Zoo. In fact, in many regions of Russia, such trilobites swarm in almost every puddle in the summer. They are called shieldfish and belong to crustaceans. Simply put, these are crustaceans, but not crawling, but swimming, similar to Daphnia and Cyclops, known to all aquarists. Only larger, they can be up to 8 centimeters wide. They really look like trilobites, but here we are dealing with convergence. Animals leading a similar lifestyle in the process of evolution acquire a similar appearance, such as sharks and dolphins. People often ask how shield bugs appear in drying out puddles and pits. The answer is very simple. Microscopic scale insect eggs are carried by the wind from dry puddles. Shields inhabit a vast area unevenly, and their numbers fluctuate from year to year. But the main reason for such sensations is still psychological. After seeing an animal with a surreal appearance, townspeople who are far from nature naively believe that such and such a monster is definitely unknown to science. If you like the episode, give it a thumbs up and leave a comment. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And of course, press the bell to be the first to see new and interesting releases from the Real Unreal channel.